Hello everyone, I am Akshay. In the today's video, we are going to create the calculator application using the PowerPoint. Yes, you hear it right. We are going to create calculator application in the PowerPoint itself. So for this, we are using Visual Basic Code. We are using just simple Visual Basic Code for this and some simple step, and we could to go for the calculator application. So if you are new to our channel, just hit the subscribe button, because we have made this type of wonderful and informative for you only. So without wasting much time, let's jump to computer screen where we can create the calculator in the PowerPoint.
7 plus 2 equal to 9. Clear? 12 minus 5 equal to 7. Clear it? 14 into 5 equal to 70. Similar way, we are dividing. 15 divided by 3 equal to 5. Close it. 14.3 plus 15 equal to 29.3. So in this way, you can also create the calculator by your own with the help of MS PowerPoint. So let's start the video. So first thing, we have to enable developer option, because in our PowerPoint, developer option is not visible. So for that, go to file, click on options, customize ribbon, click on developer and click on OK. Click on developer option. So here developer option tab gets enabled to us. So inside that we have multiple options like Visual Studio, Macro, Macro Security and so on. So to create the calculator, we have to go to Visual Basics. Here we are creating our calculator. So for that, click on insert, user form, adjust its length and width as per our requirement. After that, we have to take here display. So to take display, click on AB text box and draw the display here. Likewise. After that, in the font, just click on it, click on bold and size 36 and click on OK. Come down in the text box. We have to enter 0 and text align. We have to choose as a align right. So after taking the display, next thing we have to add the button. So for that, click on command buttons and draw a button here. After drawing the buttons, go to fonts, click on font, select the bold, size 22. And click on OK. And inside that, first, we are adding the numbers here. 7 number, just click and Control C to copy it and Control V to paste. Second is 8. We are adding the numbers as per the calculator. Just copy and pasting the button. 9. After that, we are adding the plus button. Control C for copy it and Control V paste. Change the number one by one. Minus. Control V for paste. Change the number. Here we add multiply sign. In this point, we are at decimal point. Second, here we add 0. And in the place of 9, we add cancel. And here we are adding divide by sign. Just increasing bit size of it to place the equal to button here. I am just clicking on one button and copying in with the help of Ctrl C, Ctrl V for paste, and drag here. Just click on that and adding equal to sign. So our basic shape of calculator gets created. So we have to add the code for each and everything. So first we will go with the numbers. We are create the code for all the numbers, and after that we are creating the code for the decimals and equal to sign. So start with the number 7. So I'm double clicking on it. Here we have to write the if statement. So if text box when dot text equals to, in the double quotes, 0, double quotes complete, then come to next line, text box 1 dot text equals to, so we are creating for 7 numbers. So write 7 here, double quotes complete, come to next line, and here write else statement. Else text box 1 dot text equals to, directly copying and paste here. So 1 dot text, and doing for 7th number. So here write 7. So this is the code we have to create, and after that we have to close the if statement also. So for that, end if. This statement we are using for the all numbers. So I am clicking on 8 number, just paste it, and just change the number here for all the numbers. Go to forms again, double clicking on 9 number, and change the number. Similarly, do for the all numbers. Last number is 0. So I'm pasting the code here and changing the numbers already. 0 and 0. So our all the numbers are completed. Now we are going for the equations. So equations mean the addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division. So first we will go with the plus. So double click on plus. So here bit code is different. So first num equal to text box dot text, come to next line, text box dot text equal to blank, then operations equal to, first we are doing for the plus sign, so addition for plus, after that we do for next minus sign, and we are only copying the code for the plus and just paste it here and change only the minus sign. Similar way, do for the multiplication and division. Division also completed. So after the division, we are going for decimal. So double click on this, and here we have to write the if statement. INSTR in string of text box 1 dot text comma in the double quotes dot double quote complete and bracket complete equals to 0, then I am copying just text box from here, paste here, equal to, just paste it, plus in the double quotes dot plus. So this is for the decimal, and we have to end the if statement also. So end if. So double click on user form 1. After that we are going for the clear. So text box 1 dot text equal to blank in the double quotes. Come to next line, text box 1 dot text equal to in the double quotes 0 double quotes complete. This is for the clear. Clear also gets completed. So last thing remaining is the equal to sign. So for that, just double click on it. So here we write the code as second num equal to text box 1 dot text. Below that, start the if statement, if operation. First we are doing for plus. So in the double quote, plus. Then come to next line, result equal to first num plus second num. Come to next line, text box 1 dot text equal to result. After that we are using the else statement, else if operations equal to. Here we are using for the minus sign. So directly we can copy from here also. So directly copy, I am from here. So this much text I am copying and directly just paste here. Just we are changing the signs. So we are doing for minus. Here take the minus and here also minus. Similar way we are doing for the multiplication and division. So just copy this, paste it. And change the sign, multiply, and here also multiply. Last one is a division, and close the if statement also. So end if. That's all. So our all the codes gets completed. The only thing is remaining, we have to define the variables also. So come to the doc and click here, just enter it. And here we have to add the decide the variables. So for that option, explicit, just enter it, decide the first num variable. So for that, dim first num as double. We are taking as a double variable for multiple numbers because we are writing the 11, 12, likewise number or some more numbers also like the 101. So for that, we are taking the double variable. So click on next. Similar way, we are creating the second num, double, and for result also. Double. And for the operation, we are using the string variable. So, dim operation. So, our all code gets completed. So, we have to run that. So, for run that, we are clicking on the start button. So, here, just clicking on 7 plus 12 and click on OK. Equal to sign. So, we are getting the answer. So, I am removing that. Click on 12, I am taking into 2 and click on equal to. So 24 is the answer. Minus 12, clicking on the equal to. So I am getting 12 answer. So 12 divided by 8 is 1.5. Also, we can take the decimals also. So plus 1.3 equal to 2.8 we are getting. So our all the functions are executable and our display is also there. So in this way you can create the calculator in the PowerPoint with the help of developer option with the Visual Basic.
So just now you're seeing that how we created the calculator in the PowerPoint with just simple steps. So with the following of these steps, you can also create PowerPoint in your presentation on it, the PowerPoint itself. So without wasting much time, let's do that. And if you have any suggestion or doubt regarding this video, please ask in the comment box. And if you're new to our channel, don't forget to like and subscribe to our channel. So we'll meet you in the next video. Thank you.